'Tis a dagger I see before me, the handle toward my hand.
Ah, oh, hail Macbeth, that shalt be king hereafter.
Something wicked this way comes. Just don't call this show by its name. William Shakespeare's classic Scottish tragedy is playing at the Kelsey Theatre for some plotting, power struggles, and murder. We're here in West Windsor to talk with Shakespeare 70 about this spooky show. First of all, why do we call it the Scottish play?
Theater people being very superstitious, you're not supposed to mention the name of the play, as different from the name of the character, when you're in a theater. If you do, there are certain rituals that you must follow to get rid of the curse.
What is special about this production?
The people. That's what makes any production unique, I think.
Who are these performers we're seeing on stage?
There are people from all walks of life. We have people who come to us for auditions and say, well, I always wanted to be in Shakespeare. And others who are veterans and dedicated to Shakespeare.
Who do you play in this show?
I play Lady Macbeth. She is the wife of Mr. Macbeth.
What do you love about playing her?
I love how smart and funny she is. She is certainly mean, but it is filtered through a sense of humor and a sharpness about the world. Had she been born a man in this time period, there wouldn't have been a question about whether or not she could be a leader. She would just be doing that already.
I play the Scottish Lord Macbeth. To play him, you come across someone who thinks a great deal about their actions and the consequences that will therein follow.
What do you love about this piece of Shakespeare?
This is my favorite Shakespeare tragedy because it's compact, it's intense, it's both teachable, and I worked in a classroom for 39 years with this play, and it's also eminently playable.
It's a surprisingly beautiful love story. Ultimately, it's the connection being broken, I think, that breaks my character, Lady Macbeth. It is her death that gives him the total abandon that lets him just, like, walk into battle and die.
The characters, though they may do a number of evils, they themselves aren't necessarily evil. He commits these atrocities for what it would do for his wife and himself, and give her the life he believes she deserves.
What do you think this theater company brings to the New Jersey art scene?
People within the community often think of Shakespeare being done on a Broadway or British national level. So to have it be brought to the community level provides people that chance to see it and get more interested or invested in it.
It's an opportunity for them to watch Shakespeare that tries to be as exciting and clear and open as possible.
And we're unique, I think, in this area as a community theater company in that we have produced Shakespeare every summer for the last 50 years.
This is a big year for this company.
50 years ago, 1970, two people came to me and said, we're starting up a new company and we're going to do Hamlet. They said, you know, would you sign on as a protector of the bard? I did, and you know, I've been going to rehearsal ever since.
What do you think has kept this company going for so many years?
Obviously, I have to say Shakespeare. Actors don't necessarily have the opportunity to play in Shakespeare at the community level, and we bring them that opportunity. We also do other kinds of plays as well, classical plays from the 17th to the 21st century.
What kind of a night am I in for when I come to see this show?
It's going to knock your socks off.
A bit of a roller coaster ride. Amazing work on everyone's part, great costumes, great sound effects. It's a lot of fun.
The night you should expect when you come to see this show? Violence and foul deeds done in the name of love.